Right, so it's roughly 11 in the morning, and it's against my religion, the Church of Keyboard Cat, to film this fucking early, but story needs to be told. I'm not sure how to make this video without sounding like a total bitch. So that must automatically mean that I should feel like I'm a bitch? I guess I just know that I'm a bitch. A bitch, bitch, bitch. Anyway. I met this girl this weekend. She was with this group of people that I already hang out with, so I figured how bad could she be? I'll start by saying that I have about a 10% hate factor of somebody who is extremely skinny. Unfair? Yes. But that still leaves a 90% chance that I'll still like some part of your character. We all got in the car to go to a restaurant, and I sat in the back with my fat ass all pressed against the side and whatnot. One of the dudes in our group sits on the other side, and fortune fucking netly for me, that bitch sits in the middle. She turns to me and says, "No seatbelts then?" No, bitch. No seatbelts. Those extra trips I took to KFC ensured that I push maximum density, and therefore my ass swallows the seatbelts as if it were starving. Yes, there are seatbelts, but normally, skinny mini, one doesn't get in last between a quarterback-looking dude and a chick who loves food and asks about shit that they're already sitting on. Whatever, moving on. We go out to eat, and at some point, I look up and she's throwing a face that even I, self-proclaimed bitch, 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 couldn't possibly produce. I'm not even sure that I can replicate it. I was like, ugh, something is good. My God. Besides feeling territorial over the friends that she's directing her hellfire to, I'm impressed. We go to get back in the car, and I watch to see if she'll climb in the back first to make sure she gets her fucking safety taken care of. No. She's too busy texting her BFFs about being super thin and eating a hot dog, which means she cannot possibly touch food for days after this. Oh my God, guess what I just ate? Dramatic reenactment. So fuck it, I'll get in. She climbs in right behind me, which I automatically assume that she does on purpose. She looks at me and says, "Seatbelts," and starts rustling around my thigh looking for the latch. Because I was raised with some sort of manners, I stand slash hunch up against the window so that she can shove her bony hand in the hole, that's what she said, and find the missing latch to the goddamn belt. Fuck. I mean, thinking back now, why wasn't the car on with the air blasting? Sweat was trickling down my pits, giving off the warning that soon we'd be rubbing shoulders. And I can imagine her being like, "Fat chick smells up in her." Nobody really talks like that, I hope. But really, she'd pull out her phone and be like, "This fat bitch smells like Lucky Charms." Finally, after roughly an hour of searching, with my ham hocks shaking and about to give out from holding my weight up, she finds it and secures herself. Are you sure, bitch? You got it now? You sure? This story is obviously overly exaggerated. I'm sure that she's a sweet person once you get to know her, and contrary to popular belief, first impressions aren't always everything. God knows many times I'ma see you next Tuesday to people I first meet. And for some strange reason, they still agree to hang out with me. Must be my dazzling personality. I really do need a beer. Question is, do I look like an asshole? I look okay. Did I just one blink? She was with the kids. Nope. This is very graphic.